You're watching the New Music Review on Much More Music.
Australia's Angel City set a record down under in 79 by having their album Face to Face on the charts down there for an unprecedented 77 weeks. They went on to sweep that same year's Music Awards and became the only other band besides Iggy Pop to ever open for a David Bowie concert. Now they're bringing that success to North America, and they were at the Music Hall recently promoting their new album, Dark Room. Angel City are one of a number of heavy rock bands that have come out of Australia over the last couple of years. They broke through record company reluctance to promote their type of music on an international scale, a reluctance that had North American audiences thinking that all Australian bands played was pop. Backstage at the Music Hall, I asked John Brewster and Doc Neeson about that image.
Yeah, we used to be called the Great Cabaret in the South, but, you know, since... Well, as you say, over the last couple of years, the whole thing has turned around and rock and roll is what... The scene there is really very healthy in Australia.
It's always been good rock and roll, yeah. You know, it's just that they've never got any further than the shores, you know. Even in the 60s, there were some fantastic bands.
The history of rock, of Australian rock and roll is strewn with casualties of people who try to get out on their own pocket money, you know.
Sounds like some kind of prison.
Yeah, I mean, it really is a long way from anywhere. And it's only when a record company gets behind bands. I mean, the same thing happened back in that Beat thing in England. Record companies came in and, you know, invited bands to the States, and we've been in a similar situation with Epic. They've asked the band to come over here to tour with Darkroom so that we could, you know, people could see what the band was about along with the album.
In Australia, it's very, very important to be good live, you know. I mean, I guess that's probably the same everywhere in some ways, but, you know, here, if you can put out a successful record and you can, you know, it might sell a million copies. In Australia, you've just really got to do it as a live band, you know. It's the only way you can survive, because it's a very small population, you know. It's 14 million people, and so I think, you know, a lot of the bands that are coming out of Australia are good live.
Yeah, the audiences certainly make sure you're good live, because if you're not, they kill you.
Yeah, they're very critical audiences in Australia, so it's actually kind of good, because You know, you're not getting away with anything there.
There's a lot of bands coming out of Australia. I think there's just people are becoming aware of Australia. Record companies, like John was saying, are finally going over there to see. We've got a kind of an interesting situation in Australia where we probably, in Australia, get more of an English influence than you get in America. We probably also get more of an American influence than the English get. So it gives a certain sort of, you know, mixture there that you don't get anywhere else. I don't know if it produces a distinct Australian sound, but I haven't heard other bands sound like us.
What are you writing about?
I don't think anybody in the band is putting out any messages. There's a few, for example, on the album No Secrets, that's a song about a girl I actually met. And there's a few instances of you know, it's autobiographical, but a lot of the others are songs that we just bounced around, like Face the Days, or I Don't Want to Face the Days. It's just an idea that a lot of people get. I mean, you know, you wake up one morning, you think, shit, no way, you know. And there's no big messages in there.
Seems to be a very depressing song, though.
Well, there's some days I wouldn't want to get up. I don't wanna face the day. I don't wanna face the day. today, today. I don't wanna face the day.